Taking his guitar, Miguel tried to sneak out of his house. But Dante jumped at the offerings on the family ofrenda, breaking the photo of Mama Imelda. Miguel picked up the picture. It had a piece hidden underneath. A man was holding a guitar with a handle carved to look like a skull. His face was torn off, but Miguel recognized the guitar. Miguel showed the photo to Mama Coco.
Is your papa Ernesto de la Cruz?
Mama Coco nodded.
Papa! Papa!
Miguel was overjoyed. He was going to be a musician, just like his great-great-grandfather. When he told Abuelita, she was furious. She picked up Miguel's guitar and smashed it.
There. No guitar, no music.
Miguel was heartbroken. He ran all the way to Mariachi Plaza, but he could not compete in the talent contest without a guitar. So Miguel snuck into De La Cruz's tomb. The musician's famous skull guitar was hanging on the wall. Miguel gently touched it.
Señor De La Cruz, please don't be mad. I'm Miguel, your great-great-grandson. I need to borrow this.
Miguel grabbed the guitar and began to strum it. Suddenly, something magical happened. A pile of marigold petals on the floor started to glow. Frightened, Miguel dropped the guitar and ran out of the tomb. He saw his mama and papa. He tried to reach for them, but they walked right through him. He was invisible to them. Miguel had somehow crossed over into the realm of the dead. Only Dante could see him. All around him, Miguel saw skeletons visiting their living relatives. Miguel turned and ran right into his ancestors, Papa Julio, Tia Rosa, and Tio Oscar. Miguel was amazed. They were all really there. Everyone, that is, except Mama Imelda. She hadn't been able to cross over, but she would know how to get Miguel back home. Together, they all went across the glowing marigold bridge which connected the two worlds.